Hello and welcome to another gameplay video of Magic the Gathering Arena. I am Luis Diaz and this is Learning the Gathering. So once again, as always, thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to watch my videos. I hope you enjoy the content, and if you do, feel free to subscribe, like, and share my YouTube channel with anybody you think might enjoy the content. So in yesterday's video, in the conclusion, I said that I would make an Obosh deck. And I did my homework, I made an Obosh deck, I've played a couple games with it, and it's not doing too bad. I haven't lost yet. I think I only played like 3 games, so that's a small sample number to say that, oh, this deck is amazing. But I made 2 Obosh decks before, and they were just clunky, you know, the mana wasn't right, the creatures and stuff, I just couldn't really get much onto the battlefield. So, I wasn't too confident, but I made this Obosh deck. It's really just black and red. It has the white symbol there because I have Loras, and his mana cost is 1, and then 2 hybrids. The hybrid being either a white or a black. So really, it's a red-black deck. Focusing on... Well, I mean, you can't tell by looking at it, but the main focus is really the one drops. Get, you know, Hall Monitor, Raging Goblin, have haste, you get them out on the battlefield quick for some quick attacks. But the real key to this deck, obviously, if you're using Obosh as a companion, is that... Let's look at Obosh. So the deck building stipulation, I guess, if you will, is your starting deck contains only cards with odd mana values and land cards. So obviously all of our cards have odd mana values, 1s, 3s, and a couple of 5s, or a few 5s. Which honestly I probably won't play those cards much because I only have 1 of each copy. And the basic rule of thumb, I guess, is if you have 1 copy of a card in your deck, and you're running a 60 card deck, then chances are you'll only draw that card in 60% of your games. So yeah, those cards probably won't see a lot of play, but they're not really that important to the deck. They're just kind of extra seasoning on top of an already good game if we get that far. Obosh's effect though is if a source you control with an odd mana value, which since we're using it as a companion, every card has that. If a source you control with an odd mana value would deal damage to a permanent or player, it deals double that damage to a permanent or player instead. And I don't know if a lot of people don't understand how Obosh works, so they haven't played against Obosh a lot. But, oops, did not mean to do that. People have been trying to, like, attack my creatures and stuff, thinking that I can't block them and kill their creatures because they have like a 2/2 going against my 1/1, but they overlook the fact that Obosh is on the field, so now even though I'm sacking one for the block, they're also losing that attacker in the process, you know, most of the time. So there's that, plus the, you know, added benefit of doing double damage, period. It's always a good thing, especially if you have things like Goldspan Dragon. Now it's technically an 8/4. If you have Obosh on the field, Terror of the Peaks becomes a 10/4 because they do double damage. So Drana, I believe, becomes an 8/4. Yep, 8/4 for Drana. So you know what I mean? Doubling the damage of your creatures is always a good thing. You know, nobody's ever going to complain about that. With that being said, I made this deck for you guys. So let's see how this thing does. I mean, I've already seen it in action. I'm confident in it. I don't think it's foolproof. I don't think any deck in Magic the Gathering is ever foolproof. It might be dominant for a while, but people always find a way around it. This deck is adequate. It can get wins. It can also be beat. So we'll see what happens. Probably play 2 matches of Obosh and then open a card pack. Milliere de Cartes. Italian, maybe? Okay. You know, I'm gonna mulligan this. Okay. Tome Shredder, I'm not really too much of a fan of, I guess. I just feel like Bolt Hound, same mana cost, same power. And it gives a +1/+0 until the end of the turn every time it attacks to all your other creatures. It doesn't give it to itself, but all your other creatures will get that. I'm focusing on commentary too much. Ideally, I would have played Mountain, Raging Goblin, and Attack for 1 that turn. I'm just so used to playing Lurrus decks with like Deadweight and stuff like that, so I'm used to throwing out the Swamp first and just killing off whatever they have on the second turn. Which is fine, because we're still doing that. It just puts us 1 point of damage behind, because... Oh. That person does not like control, clearly. So that's a mulligan of a match. It's a victory. But we're gonna start another one. Probably get 3 matches in. Okay, 250 gold. It's free pretty much. That gives us enough to buy another pack. We have some packs on reserve, as well as enough coins to buy another pack, so it's looking good. Opening a pack at the end of the video is definitely gonna be a thing today. I believe I have 4 packs left that I'm holding for these YouTube videos. The Flash, ooh. Okay, Savage Gorger doesn't come out till turn 3. I go first, so turn 1 and turn 2 are covered. I want to mulligan this, but I'm going to be stupid and just keep it. And hope that I draw another land between here and turn 3 or turn 4. I would need it before turn 3, actually. Alright, show me the money. I don't play red often, so I don't know what red has in the way of one mana spells. I know they have shock, they have, I believe, lightning bolt? Is that what it's called? The one that does 3 damage to any target? I think that's a 1 mana. Yeah, I should have mulliganed that starting 7. Because even though we're keeping up, I mean... I just feel like we're gonna get mana screwed on this one. Which I can't complain, because that first game was given to us. Here we go. So we'll play Savage Gorger. Try to get one more land out, then play Lurrus Deadweight on whatever it is they're gonna put out here. We're not getting the land that we need, and that's really gunking up the gears here. Ugh. Like, this isn't even a problem, really. This is a situation that we really could have control over if we got the lands that we needed, but we don't. So let's try to get one here. Yeah, no. Yeah, this is looking bad. I mean, really? If we had the lands that we needed, we would be in control right now. Like, if we got this mountain 2 turns ago, we would be looking good. We'd have a Savage Gorger out. Archfiend Vessel would be out. And call it a day, right? That actually helps us, because now when we play Loras, we can summon it back and get that 5/5 flyer that you get when you recall it straight from the graveyard to the battlefield. Not that it matters. GG's. It's just annoying when you know that your deck is a lot better than what it's going through in a game, you know? It would figure that the first 2 games I play with this deck that I really like, one would be a flunk of a victory, the other one would be just a straight ass whooping. Let me check my mana base. I think it's where it needs to be. So we're running 60 cards, 24 lands. Maybe we could do with 1 or 2 more lands, but I don't think getting mana screwed is gonna happen a lot. Technically, I went 4 games before that loss that we just took, even though one of them was that freebie we got at the beginning of this video. And that last match was the first time I've gotten mana screwed. So, the RNG gods trying to make it up to me. That put us in a bit of a worse spot, actually. I just really like having one of those goblins out, or just something I could drop turn one and just start attacking right away with. So both of these cards cost 2 black. Or they have 2 black in their mana cost, so hopefully we draw Drauna later, because that's a good card to have. If you don't know what Drauna does, every time she attacks, your opponent picks one of your creature cards from your graveyard. You get that card back on the battlefield with a +1/+1 counter on it. So that's actually another way that we can recall Archfiend Vessel to get that back onto the battlefield without, or rather get it onto the battlefield from a graveyard to get that 5/5 flyer. I don't know, like, I made this deck last night and I was feeling good about it, but maybe it's just a weenie deck, maybe, I don't know. If he attacks with that Almighty on this one, we'll sack Archfiend's Vessel to get it into the graveyard, which is really what you want to do with this card. That way you can call it back from the graveyard with Loras or Drauna, in my case, to get that 5/5 flyer. See, here's where we're gonna start clicking on cylinders. I want to put Relic Robber out. You know what? We're gonna put Relic Robber out. Try to attack their face. Hopefully they don't know what Relic Robber does. And they just don't want to lose that fire. Yes. Yes. Now that effectively gives them a clock. Because unless they get rid of that little token creature there, the 0/1, it does a damage to them at the beginning of their upkeep every turn, and every time Relic Robber hits them directly, they get another one of those tokens. So right now they have 17 turns to finish me off, which is plenty of time. Where it gets wonky is if I can manage to keep getting Relic Robber to attack them directly and giving them more and more of those tokens. Which isn't a game plan of this deck, but it's a built-in feature, you know? All of his creatures are tapped. So, oh my gosh. Let's go ahead and use this turn since he can't really do anything to get Obosh. Attack again, give him another one of those annoying tokens. I don't know why he would want another one of those. He should have just blocked. So now, since there's two tokens, he takes two damage. Every turn, every upkeep, unless he gets rid of them, which I don't think he'll be able to. So now, essentially, he went from 17 to now he only has 6 turns to finish me off. And it's only going to get worse if he keeps letting Relic Robber through. Okay, Vigilance, that helps him. Except it doesn't, because he's... I'm willing to bet he's going to attack with the Almighty and the Flyer. Yep. I'm going to use Murder on that Elder Gargaroth, give him another token. Yeah. He's probably going to quit. Now he's going to take 3 damage at the beginning of his upkeep every turn. I know he wants to do damage and he wants to be on the offensive, but that's not what you want to do in your situation right now, my guy. Because now you're just in a big hole. Now you have 3 tokens that you have to get rid of. And the tokens can't block. That's a thing. There we go. Okay. Next turn, Obosh. And then we'll start putting those Bolt Hounds out. I mean, regardless, all we have to do is just withstand his attacks, because... Okay. And that is game, honestly. Not even gonna put Obosh out. Attack for 3. GG's. That's it. So yeah, I mean, this deck isn't bad. It's got its little tricks here and there. It doesn't just rely on Obosh. Ideally, I would like to get 4 Relic Robbers. But I'm pretty sure they're a rare card, so I need wild cards for that. Put 4 Relic Robbers. And really just start hassling people with those tokens. And honestly, Obosh probably isn't even going to be a necessity in this deck at that point. The thing about those tokens is people usually don't have spot removal that targets their own creatures. I usually don't have that problem because I like running black. And when I do run black, I play a lot of dead weight and Myers Grasps usually. So I could just throw those onto these tokens if I ever do have to face that situation where I get hit with a Relic Robber and they have drop a token. Chances are I'm playing black or like a mix of black and I have these cards in my deck. I am a big fan of black, black and blue. I mean, I like control, love control. I don't necessarily base my decks on control, but I enjoy control. You put a creature out, Essence Scatter, no creature for you. You put a creature out, you know, dead weight, Myers Grass, Heartless Act. It's just nice seeing no creatures on your opponent's side of the field. And that's just something I will never get over. So, let's switch it up a little bit. Usually I do Ikora, Zendikar, Kaldheim, Strixhaven, stuff like that. Let's just go with a core pack, Core 2021. We'll buy that now. Open it. I think you could get Terror of the Peaks in core packs. Or Core 2021. Alright, here we go. Open Sesame. Okay. Pure, oh, a rare. Look at that. So that rare wild card is going to go to another Relic Robber. For sure. Big card, Animal Sanctuary. Add one colorless when you tap it. For two and a tap, you put a 1/1. You get a +1/+1 counter on target bird, cat, dog, goat, ox, or snake. Maybe I'll make one of those next, just like an animals deck. I never thought of that, honestly. So, you know what? I don't expect it to be any good, but tomorrow, that's what I'll do. I'll make an animals deck today using those cards. Bird, cat, dog, goat, ox, snake. And I'll see what I can do. It'll probably be like three or four colors, honestly. And I don't like using that many colors. Excuse me. Excuse me. But I'll see what I can make. If I can't manage to make a decent deck with that, then I'll tell you guys tomorrow when I make a new video that I wasn't able to do that, at least not one that was functioning. And I'll try to make another deck for you guys so that we'll definitely have something to play with tomorrow. And we obviously have packs to open tomorrow. So yeah. As always, at the end of these videos, I like to say thank you. Thank you for tuning in. If you subscribe, I appreciate it greatly. Even if you just tell your friends, like, hey, maybe you'll like, you know, this guy's gameplay videos, and maybe they'll subscribe or something, you know? Any and all support is greatly appreciated. I really do appreciate it. And I hope you guys enjoy the content. I will be making more videos, not just gameplay videos. I know I keep saying this, but confidence is a son of a gun, you know? And getting in front of that camera sometimes and getting your first video out where it's just you going over stuff is usually intimidating, but I will get there. So for now, I hope you guys enjoy the gameplay videos. I appreciate the support, and I hope you enjoy your day and have a good day today. Thank you for tuning in, and GG's.